9 battles, 18 products, 182 points. This was Brand Battle. Hi guys, how are you? I'm Robin. Welcome back to my YouTube channel and welcome to this new video. Now this is the end. This is the end of season 3 Brand Battle. We have done 9 battles. So I've picked out some of my favorite moments of Brand Battle, like some of my favorite products, some of the things I was surprised with, some of the things I was disappointed with. And you guys know me, I don't hold back. So I will be talking very honestly about certain products. Now you know that we debuted this new sort of point system in Brand Battle season 3. We used to just do like a point per category. But what this did was allow us to really sort of push certain products ahead. And the biggest win of this season was 16 points to Aveda. With 4 points, we've got Damon Barber versus 16 points for Aveda. Now, I would say that Aveda is one of my absolute favorite brands. So for any sort of brand to come up against it, it's gotta be properly solid. You know, for me, this really showcased Aveda as a brand which puts a lot into the ingredients. That is one of the things I, you know, straight away think of Aveda, and also about the sustainability around it. And also really the most important thing for us is the performance. The products really do perform. There was also a few products that I was like pleasantly surprised with. Products that I went into thinking, ah, oh, I'm gonna hate this. I hate this name. And one of these, and actually the most surprising, was Fatboy Perfect Putty. It was a brand that had actually contacted me years ago and said, can we send you this? And also a brand which you guys have spoken about, but I was like, Fatboy, like it sounds absolutely awful. What is this? I put it up against Morris Motley Treatment Styling Balm. And you know, Morris Motley has got a solid reputation, premium products that really deliver. And I thought, oh, this one will be a shoe-in. You know, Morris Motley's totally gonna get it. But Fatboy just really, really delivered. I was so impressed with how the product worked completely. And actually, it came out a draw. It was 10 each. But since that battle, the brand has been in touch to say they've actually changed the formulation and some of the ingredients. There's no longer parabens in there. So I will be trying that out, see if it changed the performance. And if it doesn't, and if it's just a little change, then they could go ahead of Morris Motley. I always find it really interesting in doing these in that you put these two brands, which might have been very separate and might have not really seen each other as competition. You tag them in the same thing. You see that they've seen it on Instagram stories. They sometimes email you. And if anything, I think it really makes them up their game. I mean, I'm not saying I'm like the messiah of hair products here. That's not what I'm saying. But it's great that we can do this. You know, when you guys are watching, I'm talking about it, brands start to think, okay, we need to up our game. Now from the positive of most surprisingly good, there was also the most disappointing. And for me, when I was looking through these, there was one product which kept on coming to the top of my head, and that was Layrite Cement Clay. I have not used that product since doing that Brand Battle and the couple of weeks that I've been testing it for. It was just so disappointing. It was the hold. You know, actually, this product did win that Brand Battle. It was Layrite Cement Clay versus Lockhart's Matte Clay. 11 points to Layrite and 9 points to Lockhart. But if you remember, in hold,
I've had this in for about 8 hours and I actually feel like it's dropped quite a lot. It does go back in, but it feels heavy.
I actually said that I wanted to remove points. I honestly wish I could take points off for this one. And throughout these battles, I can only really grade these brands on like their brief and their marketing. If they're saying cement hold, then we just imagine this product that's not gonna move, and that didn't do that. So actually, looking back, I should have been more hardline on that and really should have removed points. They should have lost that battle because Lockhart did have a great hold. To call yourself a cement hold, you've gotta be a cement hold. There's also products in here that I now can't live without. Products which I loved so much that I've stuck with. Some of them were products I liked anyway, you know, like Label M Matte Paste. But then there were new ones like the Perfect Putty by Fatboy. Also the Hans Tefuco Hairspray, which I loved, but I just thought was just far too expensive. But the one which I really can't live without is not a sexy product, but it's the Weller Silver King Classic Hairspray. Because actually, you know, when we're looking at some of these products and I say the hold wasn't great here, but I love the finish. By just taking that one product, that one finishing product, I could cement that all into place and it wouldn't move. You know, so I sometimes think that in finding a product which gives you great styling potential and great finish in terms of the way it looks for texture and also for any shine or it being matte, finish with a hairspray. And while it's a working classic, Maximum Hold is definitely my go-to. We've also seen and been introduced to brands in this, which as a brand, their ethos, the sort of the way they work, the sustainability, the packaging they use, that have just gone that extra mile. And for me, there was one brand which I was new to, and I totally love everything they're doing, and that is O'Dowd's. You know, reading about them on their site and seeing what they're doing in terms of sustainability and also the ingredients they're using and this sort of the whole ethos around the brand, I thought was just fantastic. Something that we're so conscious of these days is stuff about renewables, plastics, the ingredients, the stuff we're putting against our skin. And when we can make the choice between two brands, one which is doing more and one which is doing less, we should be going with the one that does more. And if that means that you're buying less in order to invest more in things which count, then we should be. And the sort of older I get and the more I sort of do in terms of reading of these things, the more that I really want to elevate these brands and really showcase them. And I think O'Dowd's is just doing such a great job at the moment. But thank you very much for watching. I really hope you've enjoyed this, also enjoyed season three. I want more suggestions because you guys call the shots. If you're not watching, then I'm not creating. If I'm not creating, then you're not watching. So let me know exactly what you want to see. If you want a season four, or if you want a break, or you don't want to see it again, let me know. But thank you very much for watching. If you're new to my channel, then where have you been? Press subscribe right now. The button is just there. There's also more video suggestions down there. Stay with me and watch them. Head to my blog, it's there. Instagram, podcast are up there. But I'll see you in my next new one. Bye-bye.